story to tell.
The Streets Fan 103 Tank, as odd as it looks. Despite being the main battle tank, but its main gun is completely fixed because it has no turret. The Streets Fan 103, also known as the S-Tank, is a mid-1950s Swedish design. Its primary criterion was crew survivability. Although Sweden did not have much experience in making main battle tanks, from statistics during World War II and the Korean War, the Swedes believed that most of the tank's losses were due to the turret hiss. To reduce this risk, the height of the tank had to be reduced, and it was best to get rid of the turret. The Swiss designers created a Streetfans 103 tank. A tank without a turret, the lowest profile main battle tank ever built. The Streetfan 103 is only 2.13 meters high, and if include the height of the machine gun, it is only 2.43 meters high. The barrel center when horizontal is just 1.7 meters. It weighs about 40 tons, and width is about 3.6 meters. The Streetfan 103 is undoubtedly the toughest tank to hit, but its main gun is permanently attached to the hull, so it cannot function as other traditional tanks. So how does the gunner aim at the targets? On Streetfan 103s were fitted with a dozer blade for which to dig our earth. To aim, it requires the entire vehicle to be turned to face the enemy. Tanks are often deployed in hard down firing position, either behind dug entrenchments or using the crest of a hill, in order to reduce the exposure of the vehicle to enemy fire. Since the Streetfan 103 orients the entire tank to depress and elevate the barrel in a hard down position, it has a very little apparent height and subsequent visual profile to the enemy. It could also lower the hull a further 13 cm by adjusting the suspension. Although the main gun's aim had been reserved, since it was permanently mounted, it was not possible to install horizontal and vertical stabilization systems for the gun. The technologies the Swedish designers had miscalculated and couldn't fix. As a result, the tank could not accurately move and fire at the same time. But the Swedish experience with Centurions suggested that in order for tanks to reach acceptable accuracy, the original design of the Streetfan 103 required only a crew of two, the driver and the gunner. This design contrasts with most tank designs of the time, which had a crew of four people: the driver, gunner, loader, and commander. In theory, A crew of two is entirely possible. But the reality of fighting, like preparing, setting up camps, and receiving ammunition, could be very difficult for a crew of only two members. Our later versions, the Stridsvagn 103 added a radio operator cum rear driver. But why does the vehicle have a rear driver? Because Stridsvagn 103 has not only one, but two driving positions. This allowed the tank to be driven backwards at the same speed as forwards, keeping its frontal armor pointed at the enemy, while relying the commander of routine radio duty. The commander and gunner both had the same set of sights and controls to fire the gun and drive the tank. Although the Stridsvagn 103 has gone through several engine configurations, the last and most powerful is the 6V53T Detroit DSR engine with 290 horsepower and the addition of a 490 horsepower Caterpillar 553 gas turbine engine to grant additional powers when needed. Stridsvagn 103 can reach a top speed of 60 km per hour and a range of 390 km. Main armament of the Swedish tank was the 105mm Bofors L62 rifled gun. This was coupled to two fixed 7.62mm KSB-58 machine guns with an optional KSB-58MG serving as an anti-aircraft missile. The main gun was mated to an auto-loading feature which allowed the crew number to be kept to a minimum. With such a low profile and a fixed gun, the Stridsvagn 103 is more suitable for defensive operations than for attacking operations on the battlefield. The Stridsvagn 103 has also never been in combat, and as such, its design has yet to prove effective on the battlefield. However, for its intended role in 1960s, it had a lot of advantages. Stridsvagn 103 has been tested in the US, Norway, and UK. It showed it could probably do well in combat, and in some cases, would outperform the old NATO main battle tanks. This result is not too bad for a rather bizarre design like Stridsvagn 103.
My video about Stridsvagn 103 main battle tank ends here. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.